filled, a man and his pig were willing to give it the once-over. The pig looked none too sure. Back at the hide, things were looking up. Here, at least, was one of the birds of paradise the team wanted to film, the male six-plumed bird of paradise. But Paul needed him to display, and he wasn't going to do that unless a female showed up. So both bird and cameraman were now waiting for the girls. Exactly how long they would both have to wait was anyone's guess. Hours ticked by without any development, and the boredom was beginning to take its toll.
One of the things about sitting in a hide for 8 hours in a day is that you start to mull things over in your head, and it's the classic scenario where a song that you don't even particularly like, or in fact could even hate, comes into your head. And while I was waiting for these birds of paradise, I had it was kind of a one-hit wonder from the 80s, which was My Bird of Paradise, I Just Sit and Wait. Sweet bird of paradise. And it was going around and around and around, and it was like my own brain was sabotaging me. I'll be
beside you now. The male kept busy tidying up his display site, but sadly all his efforts went unnoticed. Ten days went by without a hint of a female. And when things go wrong, one can't help speculating why. Was it the weather or the amount of food in the forest?
I think if one of the problems is that with the lack of rain, the fruits hadn't ripened. Now we've got rain and it's getting a bit warmer. I think the fruits may ripen and we can get all three species in one day.
Yes.
Do you reckon?
I think optimism is good, Paul, because yeah. Otherwise we sink into despair.
Judging from some of the looks, the Hooli seemed to share our disappointments. But there were other things to feel positive about. The bridge remained intact. And when the truck got stuck in another rut, there was a group of villagers only too willing to help out. If only the female birds of paradise could be half as obliging. Paul had now spent more than 90 hours in this hide. My bird of paradise. But if birds of paradise weren't in the displaying mood, that wasn't true of the Hoolies. Just a short distance from where Paul sat, a festival was taking place. The Hoolies have been using birds of paradise feathers in their headdresses for centuries, and the traditional dance has an unmistakable similarity to that performed by the original owners of the feathers. It was certainly very impressive, though naturally no substitute for the real thing. 100 hours on, both Paul and his subject were becoming equally frustrated by the lack of females. Sweet bird of paradise. The shoot was beginning to go down. And news that the team now had to film the displays of three birds of paradise in 1 week filtered back to the locals. All very amusing, unless you were Paul.
My bird of paradise. I'm surprised he's not a gibbering wreck by now. He's had 8 to 9 hours in a hide a day for just under 5 weeks. I think he's had about 5 filming opportunities. I mean, even by the standards of wildlife filming, that shows a high degree of patience. And the sighting of one hide meant he actually had to stand up for about a week. Most of that was in the rain. I mean, that seems more like a cruel and unusual punishment than an opportunity film, one of the great natural spectacles.
Fortunately, when it comes to wildlife filming, patience sometimes pays off, and a female bird of paradise finally appeared. 120 hours on, it was, at last, something to dance about. Filming the displays of the other species was barely any easier. And after nearly 300 hours in hides, one can only wonder how many times Paul sang My Bird of Paradise to himself.